to say, I'm not my happy camper. What you got this wrong?
Bruce, mate.
I wanted a van, but I could not hire a van. The next thing best for a van was a camper van. The geezer's talked to me in Italian. He said, van? I went, yeah. Next thing, I got this. The only thing is now, who's your driving at location? You'll be out of nip back and make a cup of tea. Not many people think about Italy during the war, but some of the stories of what happened here are incredible. Mussolini, like a lot of fascist bullies, liked to dress up and swagger about. But he was all talk and no trousers. He was defeated in Africa, then Greece, then Sicily. And then, when Italy started running low on food, the Italians had had enough. So in 1943, Mussolini was arrested, and Italy changed sides, declaring war on Germany. So Nazi paratroopers had to rescue Mussolini from his prison in the Apennine Mountains. And he spent the rest of the war in the north of Italy, protected by German troops, where he still pretended to be in charge.
Try and pull up anywhere, right? Okay, all right, let's go over that one. Let's go.
It's got to be up there, isn't it? Well, you see, it's industrial premises, but it's not his house.
Oh, God.
This does look like it, but it's not. Jen Lieber and I go way back. I've bought loads of stuff off of him over the years, but I've never been to his warehouse.
Hello, Mark. Oh, yes. Hello.
Oh, my God, man.
Whoa. Look at the stuff in here.
Oh, my God.
Oh, this is great, man. This is incredible. Gianluca wasn't boasting about what he's got. These warehouses are packed to the rafters with Italian stuff dating back to two world wars.
Hello, Gianluca. Hello, are you alright? All that good sorting. Hello, this is Gianluca. Gianluca, you must have thousands of items here.
Can you show me what's for sale and what's not for sale?
Why, it's all for sale.
Music to my ears. This you sent me photographs of. Yep. Very nice, yeah?
It's an Italian track.
Which year is this?
It's 43. Well, it's a very good artillery tractor.
SPI, did they become Fiat?
Yes, after the war.
SPI and Fiat were based in Turin. Between them, they built almost every Italian vehicle used in the war. This tractor was designed to pull heavy artillery and carry a five-man gun crew and ammunition. It was used by the Italians and Germans in Africa, and the big wheels helped it get through all that desert sand.
And everything's complete inside?
Complete inside. Original seats, yeah.
That's really nice. It's a beautiful condition, Gianluca. How many Italian vehicles you see running around in the park?
Gianluca,
what is the possible price for this?
It's 55,000 euros.
55,000 euros. So this is for sale, yeah?
If you like.
Yeah.
I like. I say.
Well, for the budget, I think it's well above what we're here to do.
Absolutely, we're totally good. That's why we'll get you to take some photographs, right? If we can get that moved on before I purchase it, he does. Alright?
I'll get on with it now.
I know a dozen tractors back in Blighty who bite my hand off that tractor. I don't even have to do any work on it, so I can make a tidy profit with minimum effort. Okay, well, let's leave that for a minute, move on to some other bit, because there's lots of stuff I want here.
Alright?
Janik, we've got plenty of things in here.
Who's? Why you're on Goldman's.
Bruce, what the hell are these?
They're pith helmets, by the way.
What?
Pith helmets? Are these Italian?
Yes.
Well, for the war.
As with the Allies, right, the British, the Italians were also in Africa. Like Hitler, Mussolini desperately wanted an empire, so he invaded Ethiopia, or Abyssinia, as it was also known. Now, Italian fascists, like the German
counterparts,
used to dress up, so they were found in fancy colonial uniforms and pith helmets. But Ethiopian Emperor Haile Selassie was no pushover. Ethiopian freedom fighters, the British Army, kicked them out in 1941, which I imagine is why these pith helmets look so good.
Right on front.
The picture actually,
you actually look quite presentable and comfortable.
Well, it is. It's designed to be comfortable. I think, probably, these are cork as well.
Do you have many of these?
Look at those.
Gianluca, what are the prices?
What time? I'm leaving tomorrow for
you.
Don't
make this more. We're gonna try and get about 10. Because we're not exactly sure if it starts 11 or 10 or not, so. Because I don't like to miss anything.
I don't start flying until about 11 or 11, John.
Well, 10 or 10:30 we'll try and get there anyway. I think about 8:30. Do 8:30.
Well, I wake up
once,
you don't
get up, that's
it.
You
turn that laptop
down as well.
Love you.
Let me see. Struve. To Citadel Hiss. I blew some rings. And we're going to go to Biggin Hill Air Show on the 17th of August, where you will see some aircraft like you see in this game here. Struve, I can do with that piffing right now. Look at my health. Struve. I may just press these buttons.
Thank you.
that.
Yeah,
has just been... Ooh. Oh, survival, just that much health left. I'm about to use my last bit of health. And to keep my self. I'm just going to stop here and see what happens. Thank you. I've not been in a situation that they're going like this for a long time. I put, and this is going on YouTube, and yes it is going to go on YouTube. So I'm very sorry for this carriage right now, they've got nothing else I can do. The cruiser and the short and the battleship's coming right their way. This is a British carrier. I don't really often see British carriers. That is maritime.